No muscle mass for you.
Daniel, you got Joe in the house. Yeah. What did you guys think of Tank Davis, Ryan Garcia? And you did you have a chance to watch Tank when he trained?
I did.
So tell me what you saw when he trained, what you saw on fight night.
I feel like he did exactly what he does in training. He stayed calm, he stayed composed.
Everybody says that. What does that mean?
It's just something about his calm. He's just so cool, just kind of, you see him when he's in there, he's smiling. He's really smiling.
He loves it. He's enjoying it.
He really enjoys, you know, the game. And I feel like it gets into fighters' head. I feel like it kind of got in Ryan's head a little bit. Him smiling and being so confident, I feel like it kind of took Ryan out of this game.
I'm going to tell you what's interesting. You got Malik Scott over here. What's up, Malik?
What's going on? Hold on.
He's working. He didn't know who was going to win the fight until he saw Tank train. Mm-hmm. And then he kind of said, oh, after watching him, Tank got it.
Tank got it.
How did he know after like one session?
Of Tank training? I think it's just certain things that Tank was showing. It's a lot of things with Javante is his patience. You know, he's waiting for a counter, and you can literally see it's like playing a chess match with a guy that's extremely good at chess. He's waiting on you to mess up so that he can counter, and that's what he was doing with Ryan. I kept seeing it. And, you know, he said that he was training for that rope religiously. He just kept doing it. So every time Ryan would throw it, he just knew to go under it. You know, it was just like another day of sparring for him, really. That's what I feel. I feel like he looks real good.
Okay, where's Javante Davis on your pound-for-pound list?
Oof, man. He's definitely top three.
ESPN, very disrespectful.
I know, 10.
Why would they even do that? Everybody tells me Tank is top one, top two, top three.
I feel like he doesn't get enough credit because they're trying to say the guys, his resume isn't his greatest.
His resume is incredible. What are they talking about? Leo, four division champ. Barrios, undefeated, 26-0.
Yeah.
Isaac Cruz, who pretty much could beat anybody on the planet.
Yeah, 100%.
Like, and Tank fought him with one hand.
One hand, basically, yeah. So I don't know why they keep putting him down there. It's kind of disrespectful.
When you're successful, you have haters.
Exactly, 100%.
Okay, so 100%. What do you want to see Tank do next?
I mean, everyone wants the Haney fight.
Why?
I'm
not interested in that one.
No?
No.
Why? There's no excitement behind it?
You tell me. Is it going to be interesting?
I think the styles makes a good fight. Because you got Haney who's going to try to box him and score points.
And what's going to happen after 2-3 rounds?
I feel like Tank's going to knock him out. That's just me being
honest. But if Loma beats Haney, that goes out the window anyways.
Tank's got to fight Loma.
And how does that fight end?
I don't feel like it's an easy fight for Tank. Honestly, I don't. I feel like
no fights are easy.
He's really slick. And I feel like he's going to stay away from Tank's power shots just because he has a little bit more discipline than a lot of the fighters, you know? So I feel like that'll be a good fight.
And how do you think Ryan does at 140?
I think he's going to be better, honestly. I feel like he wasn't himself as much as his previous fights in this fight. And that's just me being honest. I don't have a bias. I've seen his fights and I've seen him train.
You say he's better than that.
I feel like he's better than what he
Well, he's a great fighter. He'll be champion, I think, 47, 40, 54.
Yeah, don't write him off. A lot of people are writing him off. You can't. I wouldn't write him off.
That's how boxing is, unfortunately.
You win some, you lose some.
Tell people where to follow you.
You follow me at Daniel.Whitney on Instagram.
Thanks for following. Stay tuned. I thought you were going to give out an email.
Nah.